In this video, we're going to look at what a system of equations is and what it means to solve a system of equations and what those solutions look like. So let's take an example, you know, maybe a real world example. Say we have a company who is making shoes, and you know, these shoes, they cost some amount of money. So let's say we have a total cost to this company, and let's say it costs $15 to make some number of shoes, right? So we'll say $15 times the number of shoes. Plus, there's got to be some initial cost. Say, you know, they have to pay for a factory or something along those lines. We'll say it costs $300,000. Okay, and then let's say the amount of money that they make is, let's put this total cost is in dollars. Say the amount of money that they make, we usually call that the revenue that a company makes. It's going to be the, you know, price that they can charge for a shoe. Say they charge $70 for those shoes, and that's going to be multiplied times the number of shoes. And then say we have the number of shoes. This is the total number of shoes. Say to get the total number of shoes, you just multiply the number of workers in this factory, and you multiply that times, let's just say 25. Maybe each worker makes 25 pairs of shoes. So we have three different equations. So is this a system of equations? Well, it's certainly three different equations, but a system of equations is more than one equation with the same variables. So I've written all the variables out in words. So now we just sort of have to identify, like, are these the same variables or not? Well, we have the number of shoes. That kind of jumps out at me. Number of shoes in the first equation. We get the number of shoes in the second equation. We get the number of shoes in the third equation. Hey, that's pretty good. Okay. Now, in the first equation, we have the total cost, and that is in dollars. Let's circle that. That's in dollars. In the second equation, we have the total revenue, which is not exactly the same thing as the total cost, but it is measured in dollars. And then in the third equation, we have the number of workers, and that is a variable which doesn't show up in the other two equations. So we have three equations here. Two out of the three have the same variables. The third equation only has one of the same variables. So this is not quite a system of equations because we do not have equations with the same variables. However, if we cross this one out and we just look at the first two equations, we can make that a system of equations. And what we generally do is, instead of writing the variables out, just because that takes a little bit too much time, we usually use X's and Y's. And X's represent our independent variable, and Y's our dependent variable. And we could see the number of shoes, in, at least in these two equations, these are our independent variables. And our dependent variable is on the left. The total cost is dependent on the number of shoes being multiplied times 15 and adding 300,000 to it. And the total revenue is depending on the number of shoes being multiplied times 70. So we have two different equations. I'm going to write that as y equals 15x plus 300,000. And the second one is y equals 70x. So we could then solve those two equations. And let's actually, we're going to graph those. So we're going to put the number of shoes on the x-axis. And we will put dollars, and in this case it would be the revenue and the cost, on the y-axis. And if we were to graph that, let's see, I'll graph the second one first, y equals 70x. That goes to the origin here. That's going to be nice. And it's going to go up like that. Probably steeper than that, but we'll go with that. Okay? So this is our revenue, y equals 70x. Then our other equation, 15x plus 300,000. So it's going to be a lot less steep. Okay, the slope is not nearly as high as 70. So it's going to be less steep, but it's not going to go through the origin. Okay, it's going to, we'll say this is at 300,000. And it's going to go something like that. Again, I'm just big time eyeballing this. So, if we were to solve this system of equations, what we're doing is finding points that satisfy both of these equations. And if we graph these two lines, well, if we graph these two equations and they are straight lines, there's basically three possibilities. Either those lines are going to intersect the way ours do right here. They could be parallel, in which case they don't intersect, or they can lie directly on top of each other, where they're intersecting everywhere. They're essentially the same line. Here, we have two lines that intersect. Our solution to the system of equations is the point of intersection. This is our solution. And in this particular case, our solution, you know, we could solve it. I don't really want to take the time to solve it right now. But it's important to know what our solution looks like. We're being asked to solve a system. One more time, we're looking for the point of intersection or the points of intersection. And I think I'm going to stop right there, and then I'm going to get into some examples in the next few videos.